is. A cookie comes from the original ones of these. We're doing a takeoff on Sesame Street, where there would be a little program that was called the Cookie Monster that said, you shut me off by giving me a magic cookie. And then from that, this idea of cookie. A cookie is a little piece of information that when you go visit something on the web, the website you're visiting will put something on your computer to remember who you are. So the fact that when you go to Amazon, that Amazon says, hey, here's your account, and you can look at your account. The way they know it's you is that there's a cookie stored there. So that's the way that websites remember things about you. And like anything else, it's incredibly convenient that when you go to a website, it remembers you. And at the same time, it knows that it's you. And then the other thing that happens is Amazon can make a partnership with some other company, so the two of them together can now both know everything about you, and people have been more or less upset about this over the last decade.
And before you get that identification, they have metadata, which means they can learn more about, they can tell what printer and what time of day and who did it, or maybe not quite who did it, but well, explain what the metadata is.
So metadata is, in general, computer readable. Meta means about, right? So it's information about the information. So for example, you might send somebody a Word document, a memo that you're writing. What goes along with that sometimes is who you are and what date it was written, whether or not you filled it in the memo or not. As you said, some printers actually print data that say what the printer's serial number is.
Yeah.
You don't see that. What you can see is if you take photographs. So you can go look at a photograph on your computer and you can find a place where you'll see the aperture speed and the date and the camera type and all that. All that is metadata. And
they sort of caught Tony Blair in a lie involving Iraq by means of metadata, didn't they?
Yeah, because there's stuff recorded. There are any number of, the actual fun one is that, you know, lots of us have typed memos on the computer and we do online editing. And we edit out some embarrassing thing and we think better of it. Well, if you're not careful, that data is all still there. It just may not be you're choosing not to view it. And there have been lots of examples where people have sent business memos that have contained the raw stuff that was edited out when whoever thought better of it.
Yeah. And they figured out from that who really wrote something that Tony Blair claimed was written in a Foreign Office.
Right.
It was actually written by his flax.
This excerpt is brought to you by the Massachusetts School of Law, the leader of reform in legal education and a leader in multimedia education for the public. To view the full interview and for a full listing of MSL's programs, log on to mslaw.edu.